Hey, Mike Wolf here from Mike Wolf Mastery, coming to you from Rorschach. Did I get that right? Yes, I did. Rorschach, Germany today. And, you know, Henrietta, one of my people that watches a lot of my YouTube videos, always comments and leaves great comments, and she's been asking for me to do a no money down tutorial. So I'm going to talk today about how do you do deals with no money and low money down. And it's kind of fitting because I'm in front of this church here that was originally built in the 1200s. And during World War II, it was one of the first places that, if not the first place, that was bombed here in the city that I'm in. And for a long time, nobody, this tower, which is behind me here, was damaged greatly, and nobody thought to fix it because they didn't have any money and they didn't have any resources. And it took a priest that came in from out of town like 50 years later to figure out a way to raise money to fix it. So sometimes you just need to change your mindset if you want to do things and get them done. And you can't just say, oh, I can't do this because I've got no money. Don't let money stop you. So I'm going to give you a bunch of examples of ways that you can do real estate with very little or quite often no money of your own. So firstly, imagine that you found the smoking deal and you said, oh, well, you know, it's $100,000 underpriced, but I can't do it. I think I'll just walk away from it. That'd be crazy. Imagine you called me and said, Mike, I got this deal and it's way underpriced and I know you've got some access to funds. Why, you know, I'll sell you this deal. So doing that is called wholesaling. You find a deal, you sell it to somebody else, you let them do it, and they pay you for it. If you found something that was $100,000 under value and you asked me for $20,000 to make $100,000, I'd have to be pretty stupid to say no to that. So most people that don't have a lot of money, quite often they tend to have a lot of time. So take advantage of the resource that you have, which is time, and get out there and start finding deals. Because if you want to be a real estate investor and you want to be one of those hands-on kind of real estate investors where you're actually doing the work, well, start doing the work. Don't worry about the money. If you find a deal, the money is going to follow. So that's number one. Number two, there's something called a VTB, or vendor take back. And that means that the homeowner is going to give you a mortgage. So imagine a home is $100,000. You don't have $100,000. You go to the vendor and say, listen, if you lend me that $100,000 where I don't have to pay it right now, I'll pay you in installments, or I'll pay you in a year, or I'll pay you in 6 months or 2 years after I flip the home. Whatever it is, there's a lot of vendors, believe it or not, that will do that. And the reason they will, one, you've got to learn to be an educator. You got to tell them what's in it for them. So if you're an investor and you flip a property in a lot of places, you're going to pay capital gains tax on it. Now, if you don't take the profit up front, you take it in installments, you can drastically reduce the amount of taxes that you're going to pay. So there's ways to make that a plus for both parties involved. Also, maybe you're going to say, hey, you know what, I know you're asking $100,000 for your property. I'm going to give you $110,000 for your property. I'm going to pay you a premium, but I need you to carry for me until I get this deal from A to B so I've got the money to pay you. So there's ways to be creative and get the owner of the home to help you. That's number two. Number three, my very, very first deal I ever did almost 30 years ago. Back in those days, I had no money. I was a starving ex-university student trying to pay off student loans, but I was working at the phone company, had good credit, and I managed to get a line of credit, which I used for a down payment, and then I got a mortgage, which I used to complete the rest of the purchase price. So make sure if you do it properly, because it could be mortgage fraud if you do it the wrong way. Some lenders want the down payment to come from your own resources, and that's fine. In Canada, where I lived, at least at that time, I was allowed to count that as my own money if it sat in my bank for 90 days. So wrote myself a check for my line of credit, let it sit in the bank for 90 days, and there you go. I had a down payment, and I had a mortgage, and I had a house, and I wouldn't be here talking to you today had I not done that first deal 28 years ago with no money of my own. So those are a number of ways. There's also joint ventures. So once again, let's take that first example. You find a home $100,000 under market value. Well, in the first example, you wholesaled it. You gave it to me, you let me do the deal. I finished it, you made a paycheck for finding the deal. But imagine you said, hey, well, I'm not willing to just let the deal go. I'm not going to just sell it to you. But let's do it as a joint venture. You put up the cash, I'm going to do the work, and we'll each make $50,000. And now you've made more money. Now, some investors might not want to do that with you if you don't have the experience yet, you don't have a track record of doing a deal from start to finish and making money. Or maybe they're going to put up the money and do a lot of the work, and you're going to learn from them, which will be even cooler, because now you're getting some experience and learning, and now you can take that to your next investor and say, well, hey, I just did this deal successfully. successfully. Here's what happened from start to finish. So those are a number of ways that are legal, moral, ethical, and win-win of doing real estate with no money. Oh, another one, by the way, if you're just starting out, you don't know even how to find deals, go be a bird dog. Go to like a meetup group with real estate investors, find out who's successful in there, then go offer to help them for free while you keep your regular job. Don't quit your job, but in your spare time, go find deals for them. Do whatever it is that they require in exchange for knowledge and education and learn. Another great way to do it, not necessarily no money, but low money, is to learn how to do tax, liens, and deeds. And I occasionally do courses on how to do this, so check my website to see if I have a course coming up. But you can get property severely under market value. These are homes where the people haven't paid their property taxes in a number of years. The county has taken the property in a lot of cases, and they sell it starting for the amount owing on those unpaid taxes. So sometimes these properties go ridiculously cheap. Now there's a lot of education involved, there's some work, so it's not free money. None of this is get rich quick. It all involves work, unfortunately. That's how real estate is. So, but any of these things are all legal, moral, ethical. So be creative and don't close your mind and say, oh, well, I've got no money, I can't do real estate. So Henrietta, I hope you enjoyed this video and everybody else that watched it. Please sign up. I have a passive income masterclass, which you can click the link in the comments here. It's absolutely free. So come check that out.